The presentation is all about ambush on Mayor Aquino at the Buya Bridge in Barangay Lonoy, Calbayog City, Summer March 8, 2021. On 8 March 2021, at around 5:30 p.m., Calbayog City Mayor Ronaldo Aquino, on his way to his son's birthday celebration in Villa Marcelina, was ambushed resulting to his death, his driver Dennis Bayon, his security escort Rodeo Sario, as well as Clint John Paul Yoder, a civilian caught in this crossfire. On the other hand, two of the alleged assailant police officers, Police Captain Joselito Tabada and Staff Sergeant Romeo Daoyon, were killed. Also, Mansfield De Bonite Kong, Mayor Aquino's assistant, was fatally wounded but survived the ambush, while one of the assailants, Police Sergeant Neil Cebu, was wounded. Next slide, please. Showing you is the map from the tennis court to Labuyo Bridge. The distance is about 7.8 kilometers and the average of 12 minutes drive through Maharlika Highway at 40 kilometers per hour under light traffic condition. Department Order Number 057, dated March 9, 2021, wherein Secretary Minardo Guevara directed and granted the NBI through Officer in Charge Eric Distor authority to conduct investigation of the incident. Also, a letter request of Mrs. Marcelina Aquino to investigate the killing of her husband, Mayor Ronaldo P. Aquino. At around 3 p.m., Mayor Ronaldo Aquino played tennis at Calbayog Sports Center in Barangay Capuocan, Calbayog City. At around 4:45 p.m., Mayor Aquino and his backup security left the tennis court to attend the birthday celebration of his son, Ronald Mark Aquino, at Villa Marcelina Resort in Barangay Tinambakan, Calbayog City, which is approximately 13 kilometers away from Calbayog Sports Center. Mayor Aquino, seated behind the front passenger seat together with driver Dennis Abayon, PNP Security Detail, Police Sergeant Rodeo Sario, seated at the right front passenger seat, and Personal Assistant Mansfield De Bonite, seated behind the driver, boarded the white Toyota Hiace with conduction sticker P70970. Following the vehicle of Mayor Aquino was the mayor's backup security vehicle, an Isuzu Altera with plate number CTW348. In the said vehicle were the mayor's security detail, Police Corporal Ramil Siosan Rosales, the driver, and Police Corporal Marlon Comandante Rita, at the front passenger seat, and the mayor's errand boys, Joel Dulacen Lumen, behind Relita, and Roger Peña Gorgonio. When the convoy of the mayor was in front of Margan Construction Supply along Maharlika Highway, approximately 500 meters away from the sports center and 7.3 kilometers to Labuya Bridge, the subject vehicle, a silver metallic beige Toyota Innova with plate number ZBM392, hereinafter referred to as Innova ZBM392, was caught in the closed circuit television of the said construction supply, making a hurried U-turn and followed the convoy of the mayor. Margan Construction CCTV, the distance is approximately 7.3 kilometers to Labuya Bridge, the crime scene. At 5:17:56, Amuik bus number 34 was captured, and at 5:18:27, PIA's Mayor Aquino with the conduction sticker P70970 traversing going to the direction of Labuya Bridge, followed by the Altera at 5:18:34 and the red Yoda Renova at 5:18:47. The video also captured at 5:18:54 the subject Innova hurriedly U-turned when it met the Hiace of Mayor Aquino and the Altera at the Margan store. From here, the Innova closely followed the Hiace of Mayor Aquino up to Labuya Bridge. Showing you is the map of Margan store from the tennis court. That's the tennis court. Then that's the Margan Construction Supply. Showing you is the CCTV from Margan. Play na lang natin pabalik, sir, mamaya. Basahin ko na lang itong ibang ano. Thereafter, when the convoy reached Purok 3, Barangay Matubato, approximately 1.5 kilometers from the sports center and 6.7 kilometers to Labuya Bridge, the convoy made a momentary stop. Mayor Aquino rejoined the group in the Altera to buy turing and fish for the birthday party. Lumen got off the vehicle and went to the Hiace van to get the 500 from Mayor Aquino. The convoy made a stop at 5:19:53. The red Innova of Yoder was able to overtake the Hiace and the Altera, while the subject Innova ZBM392 passed the Altera but stayed behind the Hiace. Thereafter, the Hiace proceeded for Villa Marcelina, while the Altera made a U-turn towards Purok 1, Barangay Matubato, where the flea market is. The subject Innova continued behind the Hiace van.
Thank you. di ba? Apparently, ang positioning nila, ban ni Mayor. Tapos nakasunod yung ban ni Tabada. Yes. Tapos sa likod yung red na kayawder. Now, sabi niya, nagkaputukan, gusto niya lumabas sa sasakyan. Pag-open niya, hindi siya makalabas dahil sa likod niya, may puputok na puti na sasakyan. Yes, na later on, wala na. Hindi niya nakita.
Yes,
so apparently, yun ko lang ha, kung sa suko, kung na-establish ninyo, kung yung tama nitong inuba na color silver ay galing doon sa harapan, which is maybe coming from the yung ban ni Mayor, or doon sa puti na nasa likod, kung sa likod yung gagaling ang tama nito. Yun nga, kasi may isa pa tayong sasakyan na puputok na nawawala. Aside doon sa, mayroon kayong sinasabi ni NBI na Toyota Fortuner item, at saka yung Mitsubishi Montero na puti. Yung puti na Hilux, na-recover yun sa kampo, di ba?
Yes, sir.
Accounted yun. Accounted itong puti na pickup. Pero yun itong gusto ko malaman yung sa likod. Kung sino yung puputok na 91 bullet holes tumama sa sasakyan ni Tabada. Dapat may establish natin yan. At knowing the fact na yung si Laoyon ay sustained 17 ganyan tons. Nandun na nakahandusay sa kalsada. Sana ma-establish natin yan sa investigation ninyo.
Nandito sir yung ano namin, SOCO na ayok, so yung forensic.
Forensic.
Siya na magpaliwanag sir.
Sige, yung 19 rounds, gusto kong malaman yung 91 rounds nang gagaling ba yan sa likod ng Innova o sa harap ng Innova? Yung direction of fire.
Iba-iba po yung direction of fire. Meron po din sa harapan, meron po sa likod.
So meaning, parang nabalabas na sandwich itong sasakyan ni Tabada. May puputok sa kanila galing sa harap, may puputok galing sa likod.
Yes, sir. Yes, Your Honor.